here I am with medical advisor Dr. Horst Filtzer from Enagic, and we've had a lot of benefits with people, their children that have autism or Asperger's or ADHD, things like this. And you know, the brain is 80% water. And how have you been able to notice how this water is benefiting people in their brain?
Well, I don't know if I specifically have a priori knowledge of that, except for a couple of observations. One, if you study a nuclear magnetic resonance scan of people who are dehydrated and they have a brain scan of that, and then take that same individual and hydrate them with regular water, not ionized water, and do another scan, the scan is dramatically different. So it indicates how sensitive the brain is to dehydration. A 3% decrease in the hydration of the brain results in cognitive difficulties. A 5% results in profound disruption of mental function. And a 6%, you're dead. So it is extremely important to have a well-hydrated brain. Now, I have met a Dr. Corrine Allen. She's a naturopathic doctor in Idaho, and she has a brains camp, and she takes autistic children and all kinds of neurologically impaired children from cerebral palsy to a variety of different neurologic disorder. And she keeps them for 2 weeks on a strictly healthy, mainly vegetarian diet, alkaline diet, and kangen water. And the results that she achieves with these children are profound and dramatic, and they're not arguable, because she's documented them visually. You have CDs of the children before they get there, when they get there, and afterwards what's being done to them. And it's absolutely amazing. Now, people will say, well, maybe it's the placebo effect, or maybe it's the so-called laying on of hands, because there's supposed to be a certain magic when you touch the patients. A lot of doctors don't touch the patient anymore. But the point is, it's incontrovertible that these children are helped dramatically with that water. The autistic children become verbal, they socialize, they play. Some of the spastic kids, they get reduction in spasm. Some of them haven't walked in years, start to walk. I mean, it's like a miracle. And these neurologic diseases are almost always associated with dehydration. Kids or adults that are neurologically impaired, they have a lousy appetite, they don't eat, they don't drink, some of them are tube fed. It's an issue, and it's, again, another opportunity to put this kind of water, this kind of technology on the map to just plain help people. You don't have to cure them all. The most important thing is improving people's quality of life.
I would agree with you, and I'm actually one of Dr. Allen's friends. I was able to spend 4 days with her at her brain camp in Nez Perce, Idaho, and she was saying that she's noticed a 35% increase in brain function because of this type of water. So happy for that. And I've seen people's results, and I can't even believe the kind of results they get just from changing their water. So thank you, Dr. Filtzer.